the team in Helsinki, Kirsa, did I pronounce your name correctly? Yeah, perfect. And the presentation will be on data-driven democracy and empowering citizens with information in participatory budgeting. Your floor is yours. I'll start 10 minutes when I sit down.
Thank you very much, and good afternoon. So my name is Kirsi Verkka, and I'm working as a development manager at the City of Helsinki. And I'm going to show you, I think this is at the end. Yeah, if you can put it at the beginning. A project where we were trying to find ways to enhance the deliberative side of the participatory budgeting in Helsinki. Wow. So here you can see, we have been running PB in Helsinki now for 3 rounds, and citizens have been able to decide how to spend 22 million euros. And we have been implementing, or are going to implement, 164 projects. And we have been really successful also in the voting rate. We have had approximately 8% of the voting rate, which we have been really happy about. But for the third round, we found out that we need to revamp our process completely. We got a lot of feedback that our process was too long. It took 1 year from the proposal to the voting, and especially for the young people, this was for too long time. And then also that it should be much more simple. So in that sense, we had to change the extensive co-creation phase that we had before here. We were co-creating over 600 proposals together with the citizens, but we thought that it took a long time, and it was also a lot of resources for something, because at the end we were implementing only a small part of it. So now we have been moving the co-creation phase so that we are co-creating only those proposals that have been voted through. But this, of course, was a little bit hard for us, because we thought that anyway we were losing quite a lot of the very good deliberation together with the citizens and also together with the city's experts. So we had to try to find some other ways. Some other ways to fill this lack of the deliberation that we thought that we were missing at the moment. And here, of course, the information is really crucial part, so that with the adequate information, all the participants are much more on the same level when we're discussing about the things. And also it encourages citizens to make better decisions, encourages participations, and strive for agreement through dialogue. So this was also the model when we started the process, the project, about the deliberative and participatory use of information, that we should have a dialogue, we should have a deliberation where we have information. We should have some sort of data analytics, some sort of digital platform maybe, and then we should also have a good design, which should be user-centered. So our hypothesis was that information about the city's activities and residents in their own area increases motivation to participate in Omastari. Our participatory budgeting is called Omastari, my own city, and promotes more equitable idea generation. So this was our idea, a goodwill we had when we started this process. And here you can see that we were using a lot of different design methods. We were using service design methods for the user empathy, to find out what kind of information are users currently utilizing when they are getting involved with the city, what additional information is needed, what capabilities are required for information acquisition and processing. And then we had, of course, user experience design, How is information presented clearly and intuitively on the site? How can citizens be guided to familiarize themselves with instructions and get motivated? And then, of course, we had to do a lot of also information design. We got a lot of really messy Excel sheets from our experts, and then we had to really try to understand what kind of information is valuable and how we could show it in a form that would be motivating for citizens to dive into. So accessibility and intuitiveness, capabilities, needs and guidance, and usability and motivations, those were like our design drivers. So we have been, this is also one of the service design methods, so we were really digging more deeper down to the different motives people are having for using the information and how they're in general participating. So majority of people in Helsinki and probably all over in Europe are the snoozers. They are the ones who are not maybe so active, and they are busy with their families, or they might have had bad experiences before. They have felt that, okay, I spent a lot of time and nothing happened, or they might have some other difficulties, for example, with the language. And then we have the active ones who are interested in how they can improve their own area and community. They're very community driven, for example, but they also need a lot of help, especially with the digital platform. And also, based on these, then we had also two other profiles. So based on these profiles, we also started to think that what kind of information should be and how it should be presented so that we can get also these people on board, not only the active ones who are maybe already very used to read material coming from the city, reading the maps, reading all kinds of policies and strategies and plans city is having. So it was important for us to these were based on or based on interviews and other surveys and workshops we have had during the year, so we could like get these motivational profiles from that material. So then we were also experimenting. This is also a crucial part of the design process, so that we were testing before we were doing anything on the platform. So we made really the material, and we were running the workshop with the citizens, and we tried to find out what kind of material was really the one that got them into it. And we noticed also that it was really difficult to get them into the material we had, because for once they had a chance to discuss with a person from the city, and they had a lot to say for us. So mainly they wanted to discuss also together all the observations they have from the area. And here you can see also that we were really trying to find a lot of data, and it was mainly calling to people, emailing people, and at the beginning we had an idea that we got just really nice, neat Excel sheets, and then we built some API and then just get it to the page nicely and lovely, but it was a lot more information design that we had been thinking. But how information should be then presented? Here we had also a great help that the City of Helsinki had just finished a design guide also for our data infographs. So we had it already ready thought that what kind of colors and how they should look like. But they were mainly into the something very simple. Big numbers, clear images, pictures, maps, those were the ones that were really guiding them to also think about the area a little bit before over their own backyard. So we thought we found out that the maps were really, really good tool for that. So now at the moment we have everything on our website. So we have 7 different districts, and we were gathering a lot of information about the citizens' living there, the age groups and the, how many people in general live here, what kind of languages they are speaking, what are the young people saying, for example, what do they find out is the most important thing in the area, so that then citizens could have some information that they could maybe make proposals that are more, are better directed to the needs of the area and the needs of the young people, for example, in the area. And then we were also adding the plans that the city is already having, but we haven't had budget for them, and they are the kind of plans that have been already co-created together with the citizens. So we were also putting them there for the citizens to see that, okay, we have already made a lot of good plans, so you can take one of them and then maybe make a proposal of your own about it. So what did we learn about the whole project that we were running maybe half a year? So we noticed that the city has a lot of information about the citizens' wishes. We have a lot of feedback, we have experiences, but it should be compiled and analyzed to be so that we could be better use it. And also to automate the information acquisition and processing in a better way. But we also found out that somehow our hypothesis was right, that information is really encouraging a broader thinking and considerations of regional and resident equality. So this was a good start, and we have to work more with that one. And also that maps, simple graphs and information of citizens' needs are motivating the participation. They really want and need the information about the about themselves and the area. So that was my short presentation. Thank you very much.